two, one, go!
Did I come second?
No, you came last.
What happened to mine?
But, so,
mine was too
Kevin
wide.
Kevin first, me second. Who's this?
Me.
How did Jill, I come last?
Sorry.
Mine didn't have...
Wind is really strong.
Okay.
One, two, three, go. Mine came back. Mine like went around.
Where's mine? Oh, there.
Kevin's
right, Suzanne. This is your competition now. I've been up all night making this paper airplane. And I've got my launch spot over here. I'm gonna launch. It's probably gonna end up somewhere there, I reckon. Yeah, so my paper plane came out a bit weird, you know, not gonna lie. And I watched a tutorial how to make it, and you know, they spelt plane quite weirdly, you know, like they spelt plane with a B, you know, B-O-A-T actually. So let's just see. It's probably gonna actually land on the top over there. It's a bit weird. It doesn't really feel like it has wings, you know. But let's give it a go. I guess we hold it kind of like this, right? Yeah. All right, back to the drawing board. How's it, guys? So I've been working on a new plane, and I think she's ready. I think she's gonna do really well. I also took the time to measure the distances. So if you look down there, that's actually 100 meters from where I am now. And then just in case it goes quite far, there's 200 meters, quite far in the distance there. So for those of you who don't know, my dad is a pilot. He actually flies planes. So I wanted to talk you through some of the aerodynamics of my new plane. So here she is. These bits here, every part of it is structural, you know. It's the design is meant to be for perfect flight. So these here are the rudders. They help with the direction. This bit here is for streamline. It's quite narrow, as you can see. And these bits here, you notice the wings. This one actually has wings as opposed to the Boat plane that I made before. Don't know what happened with that. I assumed it was designed by Boeing, you know, but obviously I used the wrong paper or something. So these wings are meant for lift. So they're quite narrow at the ends and quite wide here. So a lot of the wind picks it up underneath here, right, to lift the body. So let's see how far we can go with this guy. I'm going to try and get at least 150 meters, okay? See, I think I'm just using the wrong paper, you know? Back to the drawing board.
We've been working really hard on our plane, because we've got a team down here at Plane Inc. And I'll just introduce you to some of the team now. This is Frank Schwieselheimer. He worked on the cockpit.
On here. It was very trying, you can understand. First of all, we had to find some flighty, weightless moment with no gravitational mass at all. And then we had to launch it into the air. So my job was simple. Mine was simply to make the airhead more airy. So we just put the nose of the Concorde onto the airhead. And I think that should just about do the trick. What do you think?
This is Scott Schwieselheimer. He was working on the wing department.
Yes, I would agree with Frank with the nose of the Concorde, but I think that we have done a brilliant job with the wing too. We have just used a concertina type of wing, which has been seen in nature before.
Concertina, my body.
So we will try and see if it actually works for
nothing
this time.
Nothing as good as the nose.
This is now Gary Svieselheimer. He was in charge of coffee.
And lubrication. Red oils work well, and brown oils. And good luck, Jim. Claire.
And then, of course, Arthur Svieselheimer, who is our senior engineer and takes care of everything.
Absolutely.
At here.
As you can see, absolutely fuck all has been taken care of.
A man of few words. Okay, so we're ready for the launch now. So second video, we're here, we're on the runway and we're about to start. A lot of wind, not the best conditions here today for launching Plane Jane, our new plane. But one last word about the fuel.
Well, we have been loading this fuel ever since early morning. It is, of course, 96% vodka, and it's highly inflammable. It's highly inflammable. Do you understand me? Hey, also. It's
right. I think we're ready to launch. Here we go. Plane Jane, Mark One.
Run.
Our paper plane.
Run, black fellow scatter. Run. Run. She flies! It's beautiful!
Amazing! What a success! What a success!
Good day, everyone. As you can see, it's been quite rainy today, so not a good day for flying. But I think it's cleared up enough now to do a test flight. As you can see, my 100 meter sign quite damaged in the rain, as well as my 200 meter sign. They're quite far away, so I'm not going to bother changing them, but you can see them. As you know, I was recruiting a team, but obviously COVID-19, everybody's self-isolating, everyone's far away, no one was really willing to come here and be part of my team, so I'm still working on that. But I was talking to some Japanese engineers who gave me a new design. It's quite radical. And they said that indeed the paper was the problem. So they said, they suggested I use paper that, it was in Japanese, so I couldn't really translate it properly, but it said like small, which I assumed meant thin. But I went with small and thin. I found this paper from my mum actually had a whole roll of it, a few rolls. And this radical new design, as you can see, I don't know if it's going to work. It looks a bit odd to me, but let's give it a go. Okay. So take number 3, let's do this. Well, as you can see, not very successful there. Guess we'll try again later.
Hi guys, how's it going? First of all, this is what lockdown hair looks like. Like, your locks are down. Yeah, it's growing quite fast. But, you know, that said, I have been in serious deliberations with Kinder. They're my German company that have been helping me with the plane. My pay per plane. And I'm just so grateful to them for all the time that they put into this this egg nest egg that we've been working on. So as we all know, the size of my garden's pretty extensive. Back there you can see where that dove is on the bird bath. That's about 500 meters away. So I'm gonna try for that. Got a nice runway as well with the sort of brown dirt there. So Let's give it a shot. I'm going to show you my plane. This is what Kinder and I have been working on. So here she is. Here's the baby. Pretty spectacular. Pretty cool, right? Yeah, she's got all the makings of a great paper plane. So let's give it a shot. Are we ready? Okay, and 3, 2, 1. Brilliant. That's about 250 meters, I would say. Wouldn't you? About halfway there. So I think I win. Basically, I think I win. I mean, she even landed landed fairly well. Yeah, so yeah, from me and my team here at Kinder, we just want to say thanks for taking up the challenge of the paper plane, but obviously, you know, you can't beat the Germans.
Hey everyone, happy Easter. Hope you're enjoying this glorious day. We finally had enough good weather today to do another test flight. So as I told you before, I've recruited a local team. May I introduce you to one of my lead engineers, Pixie Jovanovic. Here she is. And as you can see, actually, she came up with this really beautiful design. Really radical, not something I ever would have thought of. Very Concorde-esque. Mm. So I'm glad I've got her on my team because I couldn't have come up with something.
It can swoop.
It can swoop. It can. It's very. It's also very strong. It can hold a camera on the plane. So we've actually figured out a way to attach the camera to the plane. And Pixie will demonstrate while I stand in front. What's happening? I can't switch.
What does that mean?
I can't switch the camera to the other side. So you might have to just hold it like this.
Right.
I didn't help you. We did figure this out before. Okay, attach it to the camera like this.
Yeah. Okay.
A little bit further to the side. It's right on the edge, actually.
Mm.
All right.
Okay, do you want to show them where we're predicting stable? It will...
I predict that it's going to land somewhere around here, at the top of Cicero.
I'm convinced.
Yeah? I mean, look at this beautiful day. Beautiful
I mean, especially day. With the help of... Missy.
Oh, we have Missy as
Jovanovic.
Well. Jovanovic. She's actually down a little bit. She's actually one of our head engineers.
Mm. And as you can see, she's exhausted from testing.
Honestly, we've been testing all day. She needs a lot of attention because she's just flat out been working hard all day.
Yeah.
So let's try. Let's do this.
Okay, right. Missy Jovanovic.
Are you ready to come with us?
Come on.
Okay. Right. So I'm going to throw the plane.
Yep.
Hang on. This needs to. We need to be able to see this.
The nose.
The nose. Yeah. That's too much. That's too much. That's good. All right. I'm gonna throw the plane. Okay. One, two, three. Yes, Missy! Oh my gosh! Look at it go! It's flying.
Note the gliding action.
Wow.
Gliding.
Oh, it's gliding. It's not gonna smash.
So, how's it, guys? I know I've been really quiet about the whole paper plane competition. And my team here have been working really hard. You know, Team Rocky Jujubes. And we have constructed something amazing. And so we're going to show it to you now. And I'm upping the competition, seriously, guys. So good luck with your new creations, and I wish you well because you're gonna need it. Eat my dust.
And welcome to our newest plane. This is we had Plane Jane Mark 1. This is Plane Jane Mark 2. We've improved things slightly, and we have more flight capabilities. Would you say so, Frank Schwieselheimer?
Yeah. I mean, we say Mark 1. Mark 1, like Warp 1.
Yeah,
Warp 1. Warp 1. This is a new cockpit.
Yeah, it's a new cockpit.
Which is very good. It replaces the old urinals. But what can I say? It's wonderful. And the captain who can drink beer, it's all good because this is German.
Yeah, of course.
It's like eine kleine Oktoberfest in Dutch.
That's right. And our pilots will always drink on the flight.
Exactly.
We do not allow pilots to don't drink on the
flight. No, there will be no non-drinking on this flight.
Heineken.
It means there's less chance of Islamic terrorism. Have another piece of bacon, please, hostess.
What can you tell us about the wing design of this new Mark II plane, Jane?
Well, these wings are totally new, never seen before.
Yeah.
It is now the Warp Wing 4, which we have made.
Yes.
Very highly technological.
Yeah. Yeah, and we used a bond paper, just plain bond paper for our wing, but seems to be holding up, considering our flight.
Maybe it should be Jane bond paper.
Yes, oh. There is Jane herself, who is serving our refreshments.
Eine kleine Nacht für Sie.
My name is Charlene, come from Paris, because I was working for SAA, and I delivered a really nice cup of tea, rooibos, and some milk.
And we have a new engineer, Ken Schwieselheimer, who has been working on the seating arrangement.
Yeah. You will notice that these seats are completely new German technical engineering. You will notice you can move right, you can move left, you can move backwards, and you can move forwards.
Yeah.
And if the air hostess moves in my direction, you never know what might
happen.
There's
no seat for me. I'm to sit on his lap.
There you go. I'll lock us up if you can take it.
Van Paris.
Nogal.
So you will notice on this plane that we have flown considerably further than 500 meters.
What's going past 500 meters.
Andromeda?
Yes. A few stars. We've gone a little bit further than we expected, actually. We were just going to go out for the morning, but I think we'll make it a lunchtime trip.
That's wonderful.
This tea's terrible. Do these windows open?
No. To have windows, just open air, so it's like a veranda plane.
I think I'll throw my tea on a star.
Splash a falling star.
Splash a falling star.
Splash a falling star and
put it in your pocket. Never let it fade away. Splash a falling star and put it in your pocket. Save it for a rainy day.
Made it on a rainy day, did you say?
Yeah, well,
Lebensraum, what can I say?
Could you stop that pilot?